Today I'm at the Mammoth March in Oak Mountain State Park, taking on a 20-mile hike in 8 hours with about 1,000 other people. Longest hike I've ever attempted, so we're going to try it, see how it goes, and check in along the way. So that's 1 mile down, 19 more to go. All right, so we started out in the first group at 7. Technically, I was supposed to start at 7:45, but I kind of weaseled my way in, started with Troy at 7, so we've had groups pass us already, which is really weird starting out because you are pretty much in a pack with other hikers, but you know, everyone's gonna run their own pace or hike their own pace, so I just showed you the 1 mile mark. Probably try to check in all along the way just to see how I hold up. One thing about Oak Mountain, the views are always nice. I have not been on this trail before, but hiking along the lake is pretty cool.
Sorry.
No, you're good. You're good.
All right, so mile number 2, 18 more to go. It has been weird because we've basically been in big groups, small groups. Just got passed by a big group, so I guess that's probably how it's going to go today. All right, mile 3 in. Still feeling all right. Long way to go. This has been it's weird because there's so many people around you. You go spurts where you're in a small pack and then a big group will come get past you. Like this is a trail that's behind us down there. If you can see, you probably can. More groups. So you can't. There's no, I'm alone on the trail time today, that's for sure. So just one observation a few miles in. If you are a trail runner, you like running on the trails, that's your thing, that's cool. You probably don't want to sign up for an event like this because the trail is basically single file lines for big sections at a time. It's not very wide. And you and three of your buddies trying to run past everybody is just jamming everything up. So, again, just my thoughts on it. Mile 4. So the first water refill break areas that's supposed to be around mile 5. I've got water, but one of the problems today is you're not going to take a leak on the trail unless you go probably a half a mile off trail because there's so many people down here. You can't pee, can't fart. There's usually people around you. Whew. So also at mile 5, this long sleeve's got to go because it has warmed up pretty quick, and still making progress. Mile 5 in the books. Definitely need to get this long sleeve off. Tighten my shoes up a little bit. Get a couple pieces of gravel out of my shoe too, so. Still moving. Mile six. Still rolling. One of the good things is that, at least for now, no big crowds around us. Troy's a little bit ahead of me up there, which is good, but it has been nice not having all the crowds all around us and lined up like cattle going through the gate. But so far so good. Okay, so the first real climb of the day comes a little after mile seven. And it's probably not really that big of a climb. Whew, but you can tell by my breathing, it was the first one of the day, so gotta keep on moving. So what that was at mile eight was the charge, like a recharging station. Had a protein bar. How you doing? Refilled the water. Banana. Ate a banana and what was the other one? Some kind of energy brownie, protein brownie. So it was good because when you left the area at mile eight, coming back across the road and hanging left, it's been nothing but climbs, ups and downs ever since then. So it was a good spot to get a quick break in and refuel a little bit. So one thing, just talking to couple that was behind me and passed me a little while ago, it seemed like about mile eight the adrenaline wears off. Like, you're up until that point, you're just hammering down, everybody's talking, lots of chatter on the trail. After mile eight, when you do come upon a group of people, they're quiet. Some are struggling like myself, but yeah, seems like about mile eight it kind of got real for that it was going to be a longer day than what you probably felt like, at least for me. But so far, so good. I'm not going to complain. We're still rolling.
Did you get my butt on there?
I did not. Some straw paper, buddy.
What?
Some straw paper so you can chew on it. Just a quick update. Just went past mile 13. And I can tell you that my pace has slowed drastically. I'm getting past pretty often, but it's okay. Everybody hikes their own pace. So I got groups that come by me. I scoot over, let them go on. Again, I'm not gonna be the guy in the left-hand lane on the interstate doing 65. So, all right, coming up on the last pit stop area, I guess you'd call it. Drinks, food. Portageons. This is at mile 14.8. 3 more miles to go. I can go ahead and tell you it's gonna be a tough 3 miles, no doubt. You made it, buddy. Made it to the end. Didn't die. Woo! Alright, so back at camp. Took a shower. Jimmy came up. Gonna camp with me tonight. Troy and Heather down there. So, whew, like I said earlier on that last little clip. Rough day, worth it. Feet are hurting, a little tired, but all good. So we'll hang out for a little bit, fire up the grill and the fire, cook some supper. So thanks for watching. If you're new to the channel, hit that subscribe button. If you like the video, give it a thumbs up, and we'll catch you on the next one. See ya.